Nobody pray for me. It been a day for me. Yeah.
Hey.
I remember syrup sandwiches and
safe house sessions. Hey.
Whoop, there it is.
Kendrick season's coming, y'all. Be humble. West Coast.
Be humble.
Hey.
Be humble.
Hey.
Humble.
Hey.
Shut
hey.
Up, up,
bitch.
Hey. Shut up, bitch.
Vibro. All right. All right, y'all. This is Well, let me go back to like we're in the studio. All right.
Oh, no.
And welcome back to the place where nothing is safe. This except is episode 51.
51
of the Jig Is Up podcast, and we are introducing the safe house.
Yes,
you yeah, know, man. This is a homegrown equipment that we're recording with. Shout outs to MEZY. Taking the time, working hard,
woo!
Making
yes.
this happen.
Yeah. We appreciate that.
So hopefully that, you know, the system and the quality, the sound quality is still the same as if we were in the studio. But, you know, we're still going to go to the studio here and there. But right now,
just FYI, if you listen to some sirens, my bad.
Yeah, we're recording at Caitlin's pad in downtown San Diego.
Yes.
Yeah, there's going to be like
the Legion of Doom.
Yeah, a lot of firehouses, fire trucks and shit coming through. So.
Yeah.
They didn't do it. You know what I wanted to say? I was going to give you an idea for the intro, like live from the safe house.
Live from the safe house.
Hey, yeah.
It's
yeah.
the Jiggers Up podcast.
We coming live from the safe house.
Yeah.
But, you know, sometimes people like familiarity too, so.
Because I was going to say, like, you would say, like, you know, we're located in none of your fucking business, but you're always welcome back. Like, or something like that. Like.
Hey, but we'll figure it out, man. But
we're at an undisclosed location.
Even but you're actually. Welcome to come by.
You're welcome to stop by. Safe house.
But yeah, man, like I said, man, you guys, welcome to the Safe House Sessions. This is the introduction. You know me, I'm your host, yours, Marco, and I'm with.
It's your guy, MEZY.
It's your girl, Miss Nessa, a.k.a. Blazing Mommy.
It's your boy, Kmart 619, a.k.a. Clutch, a.k.a. Mommy, He Did That, a.k.a. That Nigga in the Back.
A.k.a. Oh. Out of His Shell.
For real.
Out of His Shell.
Yeah, my house.
This nigga just said undisclosed. I mean, I put it out there. And then he said undisclosed location, and he put it back out there.
Yeah. Make up your fucking mind.
Just right. joking.
Tell
it's
him
not
pull
a
up.
House.
It's not a house.
It's a safe house.
It's a safe house.
But where nothing is safe.
But speaking of safe, man, I have to talk about it. It's the elephant in the room. It just went viral for a little bit. And that was the motherfucking Pepsi ad with Kendall Jenner. And Pepsi had to pull that one out so quick. So quick. So I don't know if you guys seen it yet or heard about it.
I just watched it.
I didn't get to see it.
I didn't get the chance.
I was having some sushi.
Mm. You was having some sushi?
Yeah.
A lot of wasabi.
Wasabi.
I always mix that up
got
with
that,
Lion King.
Got that ponzu.
Sarabi, wasabi.
Yeah.
So what happened was a lot of, you know, it rubbed a lot of activists the wrong way. Mm. You know, especially Black Lives Matter, any other people who, like, you know.
Dab.
What's that? trying to think of the other people protesting. What's that? Something. Fuck, what is that shit? Wall Street? Occupy Wall Street?
Yeah,
those motherfuckers, you know, it pissed them off because they believe like, oh, now that I give a cop a fucking Pepsi, he won't spray me, beat me down or anything like that. It's like it was such in bad taste. It was
yeah.
like
yeah.
really fucked up.
That's why I drink Coke.
And that's why, yeah, that's why he drinks Coke. You know, and that could have been a great opportunity for Coke to step in like, yeah. see, we support this. Hey, we pass out Cokes. But next time people start protesting, I think people's going to start passing out Cokes.
Oh my God.
You thirsty? Here's a Coke.
And in the words of the great Ludacris, Pepsi's the new generation.
Blow it out your ass.
Yeah. oh, yeah.
So, man, Black Twitter wasn't having it. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, Black Twitter wasn't having it. But another quick thing of nothing was safe. I don't know if Hollywood ever just gets the picture. You know, Ghost in the Shell just flopped really bad.
They no listen.
God damn it.
Them Hollywood execs don't listen.
Mm-mm. Nope, not at all.
You know what I mean?
Nah.
I said it once and I said it again on the show. Representation matters, but Hollywood obviously know better. I mean, y'all didn't pay attention to fucking Gods of Egypt.
Y'all spent all that money
them,
for nothing.
Had all them white folks being in Egypt. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
What was the other one? The Christian Bale one. He was in that other, the Moses one. They ain't paying attention to a historical reference. And then, you know, what was another one? They just fucked up on not Ghost in the
Shell. What's that?
The Great Wall.
The Great Wall. Yeah,
having Matt Damon. The white Messiah.
The
like,
Great Wall, starring Matt Damon.
It's like, dude, like these Chinese people have been living in China for tens and thousands of fucking years. I'm pretty sure they know how to slay the dragon. They don't need your white ass to come here and be a fucking Messiah. Stop it, Hollywood. Stop it.
Stop
right.
It.
And people and producers like, well, we need a safe name. It's like, it ain't safe.
Nothing is safe.
Nothing is safe.
The jig is up.
Come to the podcast.
The jig is up.
We'll show you what's safe. Nothing at all.
Exactly,
give
man. And now Ghost in the Shell. I mean, I feel sorry for Scarlett Johansson. She's, you know, she seems like a genuine
person.
She's
getting her money.
And she's just getting her money, but she ain't getting that much money now because when she go to the bargaining table, they be like, you know. Oh shit, bitch! Your last movie flopped, so you can't be a
you say bitch. Well, shit, bitch.
Look here, bitch.
Damn. You know, these execs are the pimps. You know what I mean? Yeah. It's like, look here, bitch. Your last movie flopped, so we ain't giving you no Scarlet Witch. No Scarlet Witch. My bad.
Black Widow.
Damn, Marvel! If y'all just made more stronger female characters, maybe I could separate the two.
The Scarlets.
I know. That's my boo.
Scarlett Johansson, Scarlet Witch, Scarlet. Black Widow. Yeah, that's how I fucked up.
You are, Marco, you are a true DC boy. I tell you.
I tell you this, though. Wonder Woman better make some money, though. They need to back me up. I mean, Wonder Woman at least make 800 mil.
Oh, man. No, I'm rooting for Wonder Woman, man.
I need Wonder Woman to do it for me.
I ain't gonna lie. So.
And you know, I mean, like, the Hollywood just need to stop that shit, man.
Stop wasting your money.
The whitewashing of certain characters, you know, like, I'm pretty sure, point in case, back in, 2001, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon came out, with Chow Yun-Fat, and they had, in that movie, and it was predominantly Asian, right? And they made a shit ton of money.
Hell, a lot of money.
They made a shit ton of money.
Because it made sense.
Because it made sense. Right. It wouldn't make fucking sense seeing fucking Brad Pitt with Angelina Jolie and fucking.
Oh my God.
And,
stop.
And Jamin Sudeikis and fucking Andy Serkis with fucking Mel Gibson and Tom Holland and
I thought you were about to say Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks. Maybe Tom Hanks all in the movie. It doesn't make
Crouching
any sense.
Tiger, Hidden Woody.
You know what I mean? Like Hollywood, man. Y'all just need
There's
to get your shit together.
Stupid. Man, there's a dragon in my boot.
Y'all need to get that shit together, man.
Oh, man. Stop wasting your money, man. That's all I got to say. Y'all flopping. Stop wasting your money, man.
They got the money. So
Prince of Persia.
No
Ghost in the Shell coming soon to Netflix real soon.
Warner Brothers.
It goes back, man. Prince of Persia.
Warner Brothers, you have a chance. You have a chance. If you're going to make Akira, Jordan Peele, don't fuck this up because I heard they want Jordan Peele to direct Akira.
Yep.
Ooh. Oh.
So.
I think they're trying to.
Warner Brothers,
fucking shit up.
If you're paying attention,
please
do the right thing. Cast yourself some Asian people.
Please.
Do it.
Please. If it's up to Jordan Peele, I hope he does.
Jordan Peele, like, fuck with them fucking coked out. These execs are thinking about, you got to listen to these fucking fans because these motherfuckers are paying the ticket.
Yes.
They're the ones who's paying the tickets in the box office, Fandango. Well, wherever they go, drive-throughs and all that shit,
pay attention.
That's all I got to say.
Stay woke.
Open your eyes. And if they on some fuck shit, you better get out. Better run like Walter, nigga.
4-4.
Just run your slants.
Run them slants, nigga.
Slants.
Oh, man. Randy, man. Anyway, what's up with you guys, man? What's the catch up, man? What's going on? Oh. Everyone's cracking up.
I know.
That's a sleepy and she's cracking up.
I thought I heard Zach's voice earlier.
Yeah.
You did hear Zach. He called earlier.
Aw, Zach. Come back.
He can come to the safe house.
I know.
Yeah.
It's not a problem. Or we could bring the safe house to him.
Yeah, see, that's the thing about the safe house. We could go anywhere with this now.
We mobile, bitch.
Yeah. We might call your ass.
Fuck calling. We gonna pull up.
Yeah, we gonna pull up.
And I ain't gonna say it no more.
You better stay woke.
Oh, man. But yeah, man, what's new with y'all, man? People want to catch up. Kenan, you got yourself, you know, you pulling your bitches now since you've been feeling good ever since last episode?
What's yeah.
I'm waiting for next week.
Hey. You ready for next week?
Yeah. Hey.
Okay. So what you going to do?
What's happening next week, guys?
Yeah. What's going on?
I wonder, what are we doing next week?
Please enlighten us.
Okay.
A blast from the past.
But are we having a 90s party next week?
Oh, no, we're not.
Oh, no, not weird. There's an event going on in San Diego. It's a 90s party. And they're playing a whole bunch of 90s music. And a lot of people will be dressing up in 90s clothing.
So excited.
Designed by Colors. And is there any other information that I know? That's the only thing I know.
So but
I'm gonna be dressed up as Biggie because I wanted to.
So you're looking for your Faith, or you're looking for Lil' Kim? What you looking for?
Shit, right now I'm looking at Kim.
You're looking for
I'll be honest.
You're looking for a Kim?
Yeah, Faith come later.
Okay. Y'all looking for a Kim. All right.
Nah, but yeah, I'm gonna be Biggie, so
you're gonna be pulling some bitches though.
Oh yeah,
I'm excited.
Hey, remember, as Biggie said,
you're gonna be trying to figure out. However,
and every man shall have a however. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean? If you ain't the Boris Kojo fucking Morris Chestnut looking ass nigga, you better have your however. You know what I mean? If I'm 5'3" and I'm mad skinny,
Muggsy Bogues
or anything like that. Muggsy, however, man. Bitch, I got my own house. I pay my own bills.
Oh, sound like
and I dress nice.
I stay Gucci down to the
you
side.
You gotta have that, however, fellas.
I mean, no, I get to go to girls and be like, I'm just like, doom, 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 doom. That's all I gotta do. Just do the big old school big thing on there. That's
you
like,
got, you're gonna walk around
you
with
got
the cane.
Faith. I say,
and you gonna walk around with the cane?
With a cane? No, I'm thinking about it.
Get the cane.
I say get the cane.
I got the glasses. I got the Jesus piece. I got the.
You gotta get the cane.
I got the cool jeans.
You gotta
sweater,
get the cane so you can do that pose when people want to take pictures of you.
Wait, you get? Do you got the ring?
Yeah, huh?
You have a ring?
No, I don't have a ring.
Oh, shit. She calling you out.
Damn, I got to buy a ring now?
To keep your cipher complete.
I can't go ahead, too. That's, like, the most important.
Oh, yeah, yes. Kangol hat.
Yeah, that's, like, the most important. I'll be good with the Kangol hat, and I'll be good. But with the cane, I got to find the cane.
Are you going to shave? Are you going to go all out?
Yeah,
and shave the goatee?
I have to. I can't. Yeah, I have to.
This nigga damn near a cosplayer right now.
Because he
right.
was, like, complaining. He was saying that it's hard for you to grow your shit.
Hell yeah. Shit.
Like, all you got to do is eat some more pussy. You'll be all right.
This is what I said.
Put your face in the juice box.
This shit ain't work. Get some alkaline water, bro. Right.
Fountain of youth, my nigga.
Fountain of youth.
Shit, no. I feel sorry for my future kids tenfold. And shit, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got to marry a hairy woman or something like that.
Marry a hairy woman.
Nigga, just eat more pussy, man.
Put your face in the hairy pussy.
It's not working.
Whoa. I don't know about
what? Hold up.
Go Tarzan Jungle Book and all that.
Tarzan Jungle Book.
Gracious.
All right, what's up with you, Ness?
Shit.
I don't know.
She's tired.
I'm motherfucking tired.
She motherfucking tired.
Tired.
Trying to get my life together.
In what way?
Yeah.
My coworker Karen, shout out to her. She just she's leaving us after 10 years. We started working together 10 years ago, and she actually applied for a position at another center, so she's now going to become a supervisor. So since she's leaving, her position opened up as the teen lead coordinator, so I applied for it. So we'll see if I'm gonna get that. So
you gotta get that raise
if you've been working there for 10 years.
Yes.
Oof, man.
Yeah. See, that's not normal for most people that's like coming up in the world.
That's 10 years right
10
there.
10 years. Woof.
See, I'm working on 9 now. I'm 1 month at be 9 for me.
Shit.
Yeah, so, yeah 9 yeah, years.
Like, so I can say crazy. I have like 10 years experience in one thing, but not at one job, you know.
I know.
So if you guys don't get anything what you want from your job, out of 11 years, are you going to play Mary J. Blige? Not going to cry?
No,
singing to the world. 11 years I sacrificed.
Stupid. <He's>
so stupid. I was your lover and your secretary.
Working every day of the week. So I was talking about working.
I like how y'all carry that note. Stupid.
No, but yeah, so that's, I mean, that's the only semi-new thing. If I get the job, then that would definitely be new. It would be very interesting because, yeah, having a lead position and having more responsibilities. I like chilling. I like just telling me what to do, and I go with the flow. But, yeah, I got to put my big girl panties on, so we'll see what's up.
Big girl panties.
Big girl, girl panties. Hey.
You know how whatever that's the only thing are. We focused on when she
What?
Use your imagination.
That was the only thing we focused on after you said that. Like, oh yeah, big girl panties. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah, big girl panties. Yeah. That's the spirit.
Oh yeah, yeah, and good luck on your
right.
Position.
Good luck on the other thing you just said too. Just now.
But. Like, what were the other words you were saying? Because
I'm totally lost right now.
Wait, did I tell you guys I was going to Bali?
No.
What? You going to Bali?
Yeah.
Nessa's going on an international tour.
With Sheena.
With Sheena. Bali.
With special guests.
She's going to Sheena. Bali.
Sheena.
Wait, say that again, Killen.
Sheena. Oh, you're done.
Perfect.
Oh, yeah.
Perfect.
Yes.
Oh man, so that's dope, man. Go to Bali, go travel, see the world, and you know, a lot of people say you're happier when you spend money on experiences than materialistic things.
True.
Yeah, man.
So you know,
that's worth more than anything. You can't buy experiences. I mean, technically, the money
Kelly,
gets you to
so
those experiences,
stupid.
But you know.
Kelly,
what the fuck is he looking around for?
He's looking around all his fucking toys shit. That he's bought. He bought.
He's looking at every corner of the ceiling like he heard a bat or some shit.
He's like, damn, how many things do I have in here?
Oh,
yeah.
Looking at all your millionaires.
Hey, I forgot, man. No, I mean, this is a safe house, man. You know what I'm saying?
Kelly, how many millionaires you got in here?
Oh, he's with the baby boy line.
You're dumb.
Today, I am a master. Of my abilities. Man, what you talking about, Jody?
It's like, how many millionaires you
commerce,
got
nigga?
You are crazy.
Oh, boy.
Shit, Easy, what's good with you, man?
Man, just chilling and trying to get this health thing going.
I know, man. From the conversation you're talking about.
Health thing?
Baked salmon and spinach.
I had salmon and spinach at work for like the last 2 nights.
You trying to get ready for that pool party on the 22nd?
I'm trying to get ready
huh?
for life.
You trying to get ready for life?
Yeah, life after.
That's what's up, man. But meal prepping is the way to go. Meal prepping is the way to go.
It's retarded.
That's something I need to practice. Meal prep.
Yeah, it makes life so much easier.
I was watching
it's
hella
gets boring,
YouTube videos.
But
it is
like
boring.
Like easier ways to do it. Like little hacks, like using like the George Foreman grill and stuff like that.
The George Foreman. Shout out to the George Foreman.
For some reason, it makes me want to get up and cook using the grill. Like, oh, I'm using the George Foreman grill. All right, cool. No pots and pans. Yep. Throw it on there real quick.
Yeah.
A little salt.
Yeah. Salt. Hella Salt Bay moves.
Salt Bay.
Where it bounced off your
pepper.
The salt was bouncing off my elbow, though. When
sprinkle
me.
Sprinkle me. Sprinkle
me. Sprinkle me.
Stupid. I envisioned it.
But you know what's a crazy thing? This nigga is easy. Mm-hmm. It's damn near famous.
What?
Broke the internet. He's the mystery man on a certain Facebook
status. I didn't break
the internet
per se.
but you're the mystery.
Yeah, I'm the
nigga,
mystery guy.
Nigga, you the person that people want to know who shot Mr. Funny, Burns man. Back in the day. You know what I mean? Like, who?
You know how many Butterfingers I need to try to find out who killed Mr.
For real, bro.
I am dead serious. So,
how did it feel when you found out who it was?
Nick was mad.
Disappointed as fuck. Dude. I mean, I ain't gonna lie. Man, I'll try to find who shot Mr. Burns, man. I went to damn the liquor store, man. I dropped so many fucking butterfingers. Trying to figure out who the fuck killed Mr. Burns.
I'm trying to get a golden ticket and shit to Willy Wonka's chocolate factory.
Shit. I want something. Fuck it, man.
Man, your teeth are still intact after all the butterfingers.
I know, right? Nah, you had to toss some of those
homie,
in the trash.
I went to the dentist. Like, they just shook their head.
What?
And like, yo.
I can't say anything. I used to, you know, run into the kitchen and steal spoonfuls of sugar.
Damn. Did it make the medicine go down?
Yes, Mary Poppins.
That's gangster.
Wait, so what happened? What did I miss? What?
The status, the Facebook status got made him the mystery man. Yeah, everybody,
I'm Facebook official now. Like, yeah. I'm in a
FBO,
relationship.
Hashtag FBO.
That, and that's all they need to know. Yeah, thank you very much.
Everybody was like, who?
Who
is it?
Who?
One dude was like, if you fucks up, you're going to catch his fade. And I'm like, ooh.
Yikes. Yeah. Well, at least somebody knows.
Stupid.
I mean, a couple of people know.
A couple
of
people.
Some of them,
know.
Yeah. Shout out to Mike Hernandez. He was like, Iron Mike. Yeah. He was like, I know who it is. With the little eye emojis.
Yeah. I see you.
Yeah. 2017, yeah. Man.
Yep, yep.
The land of relationships.
2000,
you.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna be next, but we trying to work on you right now. I got something in the works.
She got something in the
don't
works.
Don't worry
killing.
About me. When you get something, you can talk to me. But
she got a little
so
something.
Homie,
why you think she going to Bali?
Homie, she got more options than Derek Carr in the offensive line, nigga. Like she got options, bro.
Oh, look at the
she taking her time. She taking her time like beast mode, you know?
Speaking of beast mode.
Here comes the segue.
Yes.
You like that,
beast
huh?
mode.
I like that segue.
Came, was in the building, and he told Jack Del Rio, I'm going to play.
Damn.
That's tight.
I'm going to play.
That's tight.
Two-pat, I don't give a fuck.
See, but if they were still in San Diego, you'd be shaking in your boots.
No, yeah, you know, but that's funny. Why I said, good thing I don't give a fuck.
You know, he's like, funny. Well, good for you guys. They're right.
She would have been sweating if they were saying that shit. Like, oh, shit. You know, that O-line with Beast Mode, people don't understand what Marshawn Lynch was doing with the Seattle Seahawks O-line. It's not the best O-line, and he was still managed to create holes and break tackles. Can you imagine what Marshawn Lynch, who's been fresh, he hasn't played in over a year, didn't take any damage, he's fresh, he's motivated. I bet you he still has that Super Bowl still taste stuck in his mouth, so he still wants to avenge that. So we got a motivated Marshawn Lynch. We got a pissed off Donald Penn because, you know, he gave up a sack that caused Derek Carr to break his leg.
Yep.
And he got injured in the playoffs, so he's motivated. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure Crabtree would like to get another if the Patriots trade for Richard Sherman, I'm pretty sure Crabtree wants a shot at Richard Sherman.
Yeah, he needs that.
He needs that get back on Richard Sherman.
Yeah, he does.
He need to get that get back. So I'm like, I'm excited, man. And even like people who used to like the Chargers are like, man, I might jump on the back. But nah, fuck y'all niggas, man.
Nah.
Not my ass.
Find another
not
team. Don't do it us.
Don't be liking my status. I know who you guys who you niggas
just
are.
Just pick your favorite team and
I know who you
Madden
niggas
Madden
are when I talk
something.
About my Raiders shit. Y'all be liking my status. Like, yeah, y'all wish y'all was. Y'all wish
don't
y'all
be liking
fan.
My status.
Yeah, pick your favorite team in Madden, for God's sakes. Don't be coming to us. You know what I'm saying? Just saying.
Don't be polluting our vibes.
Exactly. Shit. We don't need that positive vibes over here.
Speaking of Madden, if I play, I don't even know what team I'm going to pick.
You
got to randomize. I'm going to be the randomized
challenge. Just hit the random.
Just hit the random button.
But you got to tell the other person to hit the random too.
Just pick the 49ers.
No, hell no. Fuck that. I'll pick my team. Fuck
the
49ers. Yeah, they're the California team or the Rams
or random. Yeah random. I'm gonna stick with random. No. And then I fuck around and get Raiders.
You could yep.
Or the, fuck.
Hey, or you get the Browns.
Yeah. Yeah, you get the Browns
or the Cowboys.
Ooh.
No more.
Hey, at least you can be okay. You can be good to go.
Yeah, Romo, he said, man, fuck this shit.
Said,
I'm about to go broadcasting. I'm not trying to get hurt anymore.
Right?
Yeah, I heard you know? Trying to get the Broncos are trying to get him too, though.
Romo? Yeah.
They can try.
Romo.
Yeah, they try.
Bro, it's kind of hard to turn down the broadcasting job. Think about it. You don't have to wake up during training camp. You ain't got to do a crazy workout. So right. You ain't got to worry about getting injured. You ain't got to watch about a whole bunch of hours and hours of film. You just going to sit down, talk shit, analyze.
Yeah. Watch a few games. And watch a few some games. Notes.
Take some notes and go on about your day.
Put a suit on.
That's why it's so hard for, like, a lot of people always talk about, oh, let's get John Gruden back to coaching. John Gruden has a suite with ESPN.
Yeah. He's going to win that. He got his own little segment.
People don't understand
segments.
How stressful being an NFL head coach really is. Like, people be having health problems and
you
shit.
On the, and, yeah, you on the chopping block. Easy. Like, you start fucking up. You're out of there.
You're done.
On to the next one.
Yep.
Yep.
That's what I
need. Isn't a coach? This is a college coach. Oh, right.
It's like working check to check and shit, pretty much. Like working at Kmart. You can go anytime if you're fucking up.
That's why I call the NFL, not for long.
Exactly.
To him.
Mm-hmm.
That's real shit.
Exactly. The NFL is
NFL, not
for long.
You better never fucking lose.
You lose, never that's fucking your fucking head. Turnover rate.
Easy.
The turnover rate is so quick, faster than the Trump administration. God damn.
Damn.
For some reason, I felt the segue coming up.
I know. I felt it too. I'm
felt
like,
it. Segway king.
I'm joking. Hella. I mean,
but,
shit.
But man, the
speaking
Trump.
Of,
no one. Nobody. Speaking of administration.
But no, man. I don't know if people care or not. About politics or not, but we do our little part to shed some light on some shit.
Next,
you know?
Stay relevant.
Steve Bannon, he's been bumped out of national security or whatever, mm-hmm. advisor or whatever. He's been bumped out.
Damn.
And then one of the other dudes talking about, he's willing to snitch on the damn testify.
Oh yeah,
on the administration, so he can have diplomatic
immunity. Mm-hmm.
Speaking of snitching, then. I think Trump just signed something to let the internet give information.
Oh yeah, and shout out to YouPorn and Pornhub fighting that right now.
Yeah. Yay!
So,
and shout out to Pornhub with the best damn April Fool's joke.
What did they do?
Oh yeah.
What they did was they were talking about on the internet. I didn't go on Pornhub that day. I didn't go.
Shout outs to ETC News on YouTube. They put it out there.
Okay.
And basically they said like, hey, we're willing to share what you're watching on Facebook.
Yeah.
And people were like, no, thank you for sharing what you're watching on Facebook. Oh, and they was like, oh my God. And then like, and he was like, sorry, April Fools. Man, a lot of people on Twitter was like, oh shit, my heart, my nuts just dropped to the floor. I almost died.
Got scared.
Niggas got shook.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's funny as hell.
Yeah, because they was asking for people's like login information. They was like, thanks. We're going to use this.
We're going to share it.
We're going to share it on your page on like Facebook and shit.
Right.
This is what you like to watch.
Dude, that's how I felt.
We're going to look at your history right now.
On Facebook, when they first started putting like the camera roll like on top, like all your pictures and stuff. And then I was like, I remember I was on Facebook like after the update and I saw like some of my pictures that shouldn't have been there. And I was like, and I was freaking out because I thought that I had posted that shit, but it's like, oh, it's only for like you to see or whatever.
Yeah.
But I was like, oh shit.
It was asking you if you wanted
to
share.
If you want to share the pictures and stuff. But it's not official on there. But then you post on there.
But that shit scared the fuck out of me. Yeah. I was like, why is this here?
What the fuck? Yeah. No, no.
Yeah, I took a picture in the bathroom to do like a before after type of thing,
uh-huh.
And I seen on Facebook, I'm like, what the fuck?
Right?
delete. No, not post. Delete. Fuck. Facebook.
That's what happened to me on Snapchat. Remember that story? Oh my gosh. Never again.
Shout out to Matt Hardy with delete.
delete.
Yeah, they came back to the WWE.
Oh yeah, WrestleMania, man. I know you're a wrestling fan. So what happened?
Man, well, the Hardy Boys came back. It was a good time. A lot of people were excited. They didn't even know they were coming. So everybody's like, so they was like, I think it was like three teams. They were fighting for the belts and stuff. And then the New Day, if you guys are wrestling fans.
Bootios.
Yeah, Bootios. They said, hey, we got another team coming out. And they played the Hardy Boys music. The crowd went nuts. And, you know, Jeff and Matt did their thing, and they won it, and people got excited. But the biggest thing was The Undertaker finally retired.
Oh yeah, on Twitter though, like, right?
No, he retired in the ring. So he lost to Roman Reigns. He's like, a lot of people don't like Roman Reigns at all. But I guess he's trying to give him have him over, to basically give him a push and stuff. Because basically he wanted to give back to the WWE because he wanted to push people. Like, that's what happened to Brock Lesnar, because Brock Lesnar finally broke his streak and now he's a very popular wrestler. In the industry
because of that.
A lot of people love. He beat Goldberg at WrestleMania. So Goldberg killed him twice. Mm-hmm. He killed him twice in like Goldberg killed him like 5 seconds. He killed him like in 10 seconds.
Yeah, like Jackhammer was like, and that was it.
Yeah, but see, people were,
the contract was up, so they were gonna let Brock Lesnar. I mean, you can't just like let the dude defend the title and reign.
Right.
Well, my contract's up, so here's the belt.
He'll step into the octagon with the damn belt on still.
Yeah, shit, that's what happened to Bret Hart. I mean, he's going to go to WCW, and Vince McMahon, like, hell nah, you're not going to leave my federation, leaving the WWE, you be the champion. So that's what the Montreal school drop, and that's what happened.
Yeah.
But back to that, yeah, but so Undertaker lost. They didn't say, thank you, Taker, you know, they said, you know, for another match and stuff. He's about to go outside as usual. He walks slow, go back and stuff. And then he stopped. He went back. And I said, don't do it. I was like, damn it, don't do it. And he got in the middle ring. When he took off his gloves, I'm like, yep, that's it. Everybody was like, wow. He took off his gloves. He put it down. He took off his jacket. He put it down again. He took the hat very slowly.
Let me guess. He put it down.
He put it down.
Man.
And people were like, wow, like, and then he put on Twitter and said that I'm done.
Damn. Undertaker's done.
Yeah.
I'm tired.
He's finally tired. But it makes
somebody put me in a tombstone.
I'm tired of choke slamming motherfuckers.
I need a cat this time.
Well, it makes sense because like there's pretty much nobody else to fight. Like he pretty much fought almost every wrestler.
Yeah. I have fought and beaten everybody.
There's nobody else. Like if you're talking WrestleMania next year, like there's nobody else. Other than Goldberg, but I mean,
Kane, put me in the casket with the pallbearer.
Yeah,
I'm ready to rest.
Man, my
back hurts.
I always told him like I always felt that he's his funeral gonna be the dopest funeral ever. I'm dead serious. I'm pretty sure, no pun intended, but I think his funeral be awesome. And also too, I was going to say, it was something else I already mentioned too.
Well, to piggyback off of Taker retiring, and I think Goldberg the next day, he probably said he's going to walk away from wrestling too.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it was just
thing. I mean, it is what it is, man. He's 50. People get older, they, you know, they got to go on the next chapter of their lives. I mean, I guess 2017 is the year of retiring.
Yeah.
Because, you know, Hugh Jackman was like, hey, I can't keep doing this Wolverine shit anymore. Undertaker's like, hey, I can't keep chokeslamming motherfuckers and tombstoning them all the time. And Goldberg is like, I can't keep spearing jackhammering motherfuckers, man. I'm getting tired. I you know, motherfuckers got pension plans and fucking retirements to think about.
401ks.
401ks, you know, whatever the fuck, IRAs, whatever the fucking WWE be giving it. You know what I mean?
Man, yeah, it was pretty sad, but. Iron Favorite, it's so funny because I remember when I was a kid watching Undertaker. Me and my brother, we was talking like, man, who would you fight? Who would you wrestle against? And I was like, the Million Dollar Man. I'm like, why? He was like, man, we lose, man, we get $100. He put it in your mouth about that. Because every time you lose to the Million Dollar Man, he put $100 in your mouth. He's like, dude, like, you know, we're kids. Like, back then, that was
and then his tag
money.
Team partner, the IRS, would snatch it out of your mouth, too.
That's some bullshit.
You've been audited, bitch.
That's messed. I never thought about that,
what
dude.
What the fuck?
Yeah, it's like, huh? Wait, like, what the hell?
And then you got one nigga spending money, the other one auditing the other motherfuckers. You know what I mean?
That sounds like the government right there.
Aaron R. Shyster. Yeah. And then my brother asked, I had somebody ask, what, so who did you want to mess with? I'm like, The Undertaker. He was like, why? He said, man, he put you in the body bag. I'm like, yeah, he put you in the body bag. Back in the day when he started, he used to put like the jobbers, like the nobodies and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, after he's done with them, he put them in a body bag and he just takes them, he just picks them up and then takes them. That scared the shit out of me when I was a kid. I'm like, hell no.
You know what I would have said? I'd have been like, yeah, he'd have put me in a casket. That mean I'd have been fresh to death.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. Boy, oh, you're like, man. But I mean, you're like about what, six or something like that? I'm like, I pressed the death thing. Shit.
Hey, Jordans was coming out, so you know.
Jordans, everybody got their Royal Blues.
Oh God.
I missed out on the Royals, but I know somebody who cops them.
I hope you get a crease in the motherfuckers. I'm hating. No, I'm just joking. I'm joking. Nah, I haven't been.
Hella hating.
I'm just joking. I'm joking.
Hella hating.
I'm joking. I haven't been on Jordans that much lately. You know what I mean?
All the way off.
I'm just like, give me some free runs, and I'm cool.
I saw a snap. I saw a live snap, and I was like, Marco got some J's on? What? And she was like, yeah. She's like, he said he doesn't really wear much. I was like, I know. He's staying some Nike Freeze.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right.
Nike Freeze are hella comfortable,
they
man.
Are. They
you
are.
You and your grown man shit. That's
I'm just saying.
I've been out for a while myself, too. The last shoe I bought was like the Cool Grays. That was the last shoe I bought for myself.
I bought the threes. I had some like infrared threes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So yes.
But we were just strolling in the mall during tax season.
Mm-hmm.
So you know,
oh, you asking for it?
Yeah. So yeah. We stumble upon these shoes. We're like, they're still here.
Was I there? I was there too, right?
Nah, I was in LA with my cousin Rod Gerard.
Okay.
Shout out to Roddy Piper.
Roddy Piper.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
So
hot rod.
Is that his real name?
No, I just said his real name, Gerard. Why would I say? Why would I want to say his real name?
Oh, man. That was fun.
Shout out to Jay.
Yeah.
Because that's what he'll tell you. You'll be like, what's your name? Jay.
Yeah. But I've been out for a while, but this is the one shoe I actually want to get. It's coming in like a couple weeks. It's the 11 Lowe's, but the North Carolina blue one, ones.
You know which?
That was the one I wanted to get when I was in high school.
You know what North Carolina J's I want?
What, one?
I want the Jumpman.
Oh, my
Yo,
God.
Speaking of North Carolina, what are you guys' thoughts on that game?
It was a close game.
It was a close game.
It was a good game.
Yeah, I know you're a Duke fan. How do you feel about it?
I mean,
a lot of people said the referees were fucking up that game, though.
I heard, yeah.
LeBron and D Wade was calling them out.
Mm-hmm. Well, unfortunately, I had to tell my brothers, like, congratulations, your fucking team won. Because he's a Carolina fan. I'm a Duke
fan.
He's Oh, Michael Jordan. Shit.
Yeah, my sister's a diehard Tar Heels fan.
Vince Carter. Yeah. James Worthy? Who the fuck
is
that?
No. My brother is a straight Jordan dude. I mean, hell, my niece's name is Jordan, for God's sake. So,
The last Jordans I got was the gold medal, the 11.
The gold medals?
Yeah.
Damn.
Good for you. I'm happy for you.
Why? You couldn't get them?
Hell no.
Yeah, what was the last Jordan you had, Marco?
I was sitting outside nowhere after we got the Space Jam.
No. I had the Cool Grays.
Oh, you had the Cool Grays. That was the last one. The
but
he got the Wolf. He got the Wolf Grays.
No.
I mean, have the Wolf Grays.
That's someone else. That's DN.
I thought you had them.
That's DN.
No, that's Kmart.
You got
that's
Raging
Kmart.
Bulls, though, too.
No, that's Kmart.
Nah, that's DN, Mr. Howard, right there.
Don't you got the Raging Bulls?
No, I got the Toro Pack, yeah.
That's still sick.
Yeah, Toro Pack. I was like, yeah.
I still have my
them shoes bombing the blood.
It's so
pretty much.
Oh my gosh.
I can't.
I remember a long time ago when Dom did a show out here and Scheme was like, hey.
That blood ass thing.
He's like, look at your shoe, blood. Look at your blood, Damu. Damu. Nah, man. Nigga with red shoes. That's all.
but if it was like recently, but like I'm just a podcaster with red shoes.
I was a blogger with red shoes. Now I'm a podcaster with red shoes.
Hey, man.
Yeah.
He'd be like, hey, man, I'm just a podcaster with red shoes. Man. I usually wear my free runs, man, but tonight, you know.
The explanation.
But you gonna wear them today, huh?
Today I
when
got
I see
time.
You going right. You outside with these
red, wearing red in random shoes at a fucking St. Patrick's Day Lincoln Park is a no no.
Oh,
you're trying to get killed.
They thinking you from the sky and shit. I'm not even say it.
You ain't from around here.
You disrespectful, huh?
Right.
No sir.
Hey, homie. What you wearing them shoes from, homie? You from Brosstown or something, homie? You gotta handle that, homie. Nigga, cut his run this phase real quick, homie.
You stupid.
Hey, what's up, man? Nice shoes. You got a fade in the back.
Hey, y'all, homie. You gotta run this fight real quick, homie. Like, for real shit, homie.
I ain't talking about getting a haircut. This
stupid. I'm lying
nigga,
you
I'm
up.
About to, I'm about to you put your ass quick. To sleep, homie. And I ain't talking about Claire Huxtable, nigga.
Oh, my God.
No, you
didn't.
Word.
Yes, I did.
Oh, no. Word.
Y'all
are
dumb.
Oh, man. Yeah. But then, you know, like in the intro of our podcast, it's Kendrick season. Yep. And I know
yep.
West Coast be fired up.
West Coast. High power.
High power.
Kendrick Lamar.
I jump right in and fall asleep. Fall asleep.
Bitch, be humble.
Be humble.
Shut up, bitch.
You are the death of me.
Sit down.
Little bitch.
The death of me.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know, there's, you know, a lot of people talked about Kendrick's work, you know, critically acclaimed work, Good Kid, Bad City, and
To Pimp a
Butterfly. Now, a lot of people are suspecting that he's going to go the more mainstream route. Is that, would you say, the direction that Kendrick is going to take his album?
It's very actually hard to say, because when Good Kid, Mad City came out, he said that he wanted to get the mainstream thing first with the West Coast stuff and music and everything that appeals a lot for West Coast. And then so now he finally got the recognition. He finally decided what he wanted to do was Pimp a Butterfly, and that's why he did that, because now he got the budget.
He has been.
That Tupac interview was still like tripping me out sometimes.
Yeah,
the way he did that.
Yeah, so he did. That's what he wanted to do. Now he's like, okay, now I got. I got everything I wanted. Now let me do what I want to do, and that's what he did. Is a Pimp a Butterfly. That's what he really wanted to do, because he didn't want to do Pimp a Butterfly first, because he didn't want to go through other people.
First
impressions, exactly. So that's what he did. So third one, I mean, he's still open more than ever. So now he can do pretty much whatever the hell.
Now,
he wants.
You know, that one line, let me see if I can find it.
Is it from his
from the song?
Okay.
And he talks about you know, he want women to be natural.
Oh, from the song Humble.
That Photoshop part.
Stretch marks.
Why are women more, it seems like women are offended by that.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
And I think it was mainly sisters, like black women.
Yeah. Hey, sisters, why are y'all offended by that?
I know, right?
Don't ask me.
Like he's trying to, like, give you guys, like, encouragement to, you know, love yourself naturally. And don't give me that shit because he's with his light-skinned, curly-haired girlfriend been with him since day one. Let's not forget that. High school sweetheart, been with his ass since day one.
You can't beat that.
You can't discredit Kendrick Lamar because he's with his high school sweetheart, so don't give me that bullshit.
Sit your black ass down.
I mean, when I see guys post stuff about, like, women being natural and, like, or they make any type of post about, like, women wearing makeup, I always read the comments, and girls always be trying to go in on them. Well, obviously, the ones that wear makeup.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I guess it's just, I don't know.
Yeah, it's real back there.
They must really.
They take that shit seriously.
They must really hate that. Like they take it as, like, we're bashing them, like.
Yeah,
no.
Yeah,
we're talking to the ones specifically you that's wearing them. Like, why don't you try not wearing it? See what happens.
But you got to remember, there are women.
Who are not Alicia Keys.
Who spent a lot of money on getting them booties and getting all that augmentation done. They spent thousands and thousands of dollars, and now they're probably like, oh, now you tell me to be natural? Now I gotta take these implants off.
But see, that's when
you said what?
It's like, oh, now you're telling me to be natural after I got these, you know, got these titties done, this ass done, the set, you know,
that's
and this lipo.
That's when we Batman slap him like he slapped Robin.
Yeah.
Oh,
it's like, I've been trying to tell you this for years, bitch. You literally hear us out and then do the exact opposite. It's like, what do you think about this? I want you to be all natural. Okay. And go to the Mac store and shit.
But it's because they listen to, like, the songs, like the rappers and stuff, and what they talking about, as opposed to someone who they would actually have a chance with, and not just be a fucking.
So obviously,
I mean, yeah, I mean, it's okay. I mean, he's I don't know why they're thinking to be bash on him. Basically saying like, you know, he that's his opinion, like his preference. Like he wanted to be everything natural. So I mean, you can still do whatever you want. I mean, you love yourself. If you feel like you,
even he made a song called "I Love My Eye."
Like, yeah, I shit. Love myself. I mean, God,
he had another song. With
it was
no,
a single.
No makeup. You know what I mean? In yep. Section 80.
Section 80.
Yep. Like so, none of the shit that he's saying is fucking brand new.
Right.
You know what I mean.
I mean, much. Apparently they didn't even listen to his old shit. So
no, they obviously they didn't. Yeah. And, but a lot of people
they just ran
maybe
back
because
to
the I mean the visuals in the video.
The visuals fucking dope. Like
that's no, I know, but that's yeah. what I'm saying. Maybe that's why the females probably got offended.
What?
Like, hey man, real niggas like cellulite and stretch marks.
Fuck yeah.
He ain't a real nigga. He like, oh, you just got cellulite and stretch marks. Shut the fuck up, nigga. You shut up.
Makeup just get in the way.
Like stress marks to the cellulite.
I want
to
see them. I want to see them tiger stripes. You know
yep.
what I mean?
Hey,
you earned your
song,
stripes.
That Kevin Hart song, man, that's my shit.
You know what I mean? Yes. Let me know
stress
it's real.
Stress marks to the cellulite.
That's let me know when it's
but
real.
But what I've always said about makeup is it's supposed to enhance your beauty, not transform it. And a lot of these bitches.
Oh my God! I seen them before and afters, and
oh yeah,
Optimus Prime right. and shit.
Man, I don't think I just. The only thing I can say is.
They even, but check it out. Like y'all seen the YouTube videos? They done took it to a whole nother
yeah.
level. Even
yeah.
a world star, like it's motherfuckers that's totally different.
Yes.
It look like a curtain.
This
was
a girl that was
different.
A totally different color tone, and she
yes.
just painted her whole body with makeup and look.
Make it look like a cartoon character, man. It's just
scary
like,
shit, man.
Yeah, I mean, you can touch up and stuff like
you
that.
Find
here,
yourself
but don't
you
don't
find
like,
yourself a real one out here. Being single can be scary out here, man. You don't know what
yep.
the fuck you fucking with.
Yep, y'all need to find yourself somebody real quick.
Well,
no,
I mean, you wake up and you don't look like the same thing.
I always crack up.
Fall for the okie doke.
I always crack up when people be like, oh, my first day, I'm going to take her swimming. I'm like, y'all stupid.
No, you're not, nigga.
No, you're not. Swimming, fool.
She know that trick too now. What? You going to take me swimming? I'm going to go to
waterproof.
Mac, get that waterproof.
Waterproof makeup.
Get that waterproof makeup.
Man. This was like in the 90s, man. You probably would have a chance of something like that, man. But I'm just saying, like, it's 2017.
See, but they were like
technologies.
There were like women in the 80s that were like flat chested, but they were still like pretty women. You know,
yeah.
they weren't curvaceous.
Even in the
you know,
90s. Like,
you
if
got,
you,
you
watch
got,
like a
you had like Vanity,
video.
You had Apollonia.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You had yeah. them. And then the 90s, they were still natural. I mean, like,
Aaliyah.
You know, you had Aaliyah. In the movies, you had Robin Givens. Robin Givens was bad back then. She had a big-ass
Halle
forehead,
Berry.
But she was still bad as fuck.
Yeah.
Halle Berry.
Halle Berry.
Boomerang Halle Berry, who still my boyhood crush.
Hey, that's your favorite
I don't blame
Halle.
You.
Yes, that's my favorite Halle right there, Boomerang
like
Halle.
Swordfish.
Love should have kept your ass home at night.
I like
yeah.
it's, for me, it's between Swordfish and because
she showed
007.
Her titties.
She's coming out that water on 007.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Oh,
shit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
like they're, these were beautiful women without really any.
He did the finger walk.
Any augmentation. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then, like, I think I would have to say the pornification of women, you know, you had, like, let's say the WWE divas.
Mm-hmm.
Yep,
you know, you
yep.
had Sable, you had Sunny.
Mm-hmm.
They had like the big ass titties
and muscles.
And muscles.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So it kind of transitioned into that point.
Rest in
you know
peace.
What I mean?
Yes.
And,
she's
you know,
awesome. She's actually awesome.
The
person.
IG models, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You see,
yeah.
You see all the IG models, you see your, you know, your Tory Brixes, your. India loves.
It causes people to
and,
be
and it causes people to be insecure, but in the same time, to compete as well. Like, I don't know where you guys live, wherever you guys are listening to us, but we live in Southern California, where it's really competitive for women to stand out, you know, amongst each other. I mean, even though they're not in competition with each other, but in some ways they are. And the same thing about men. You know what I mean? Like, men go to the gym. Yeah, they want to be healthy. Want to do this, but they want to look presentable when they go out and socialize with women.
Mm-hmm.
It's only natural.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, and word of the wise, you gotta get fit when you come down here. That's real shit.
Yeah, I mean, not everyone has to be fit, but I mean, that's just the main thing.
Well, yeah,
mostly
everybody's mostly like among athletic and fit. They going out.
I be seeing
like
some
that.
Big dudes. I be pulling some bad motherfuckers, man.
Hey,
I be trying to figure that shit out. Like,
he must have a nice personality. He's now very charming.
He must have the gift of gab.
But remember, I had or his pockets are combo fat, with no you fun. About that. Remember? About like being insecure and stuff.
Yeah, I remember that.
Mm-hmm. We all have our insecurities,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, nobody's definitely. Yeah.
No one's perfect.
You know what's funny is like, yeah, even like saying, man, I have insecurities too. Like, and he's like, damn, you look good. Like, I have insecurities too. It's like, yeah.
Girl, you look good though. Once you back that thing up.
Yeah.
And she'll do it. So you play that
we
song.
Think they look good. They have insecurities. A lot of people don't even know. It's like,
you know, you never know. She might have like a half of a pinky toe or something.
Half
that,
of
right?
The
you know, like you know, you never know. Like, yeah, man, she might, have, you know, like fucking Megan Fox got that web thumb that she has that you know they don't show in the movies. You ever seen her thumb? It's fucking like webbed and shit. It's like weird.
You never know, man.
You just never know.
She might have a boil on her shoulder. Or
yeah,
something.
A boil on her shoulder.
Well, she did tattoo her.
She had my hair in weird places.
I've
like,
had guys ask me, like, what's wrong with you? There has to be something wrong with you. And I'm like, I don't know. And they'll be asking stuff like, do you have a sixth toe? Do you have it? And I'm just like, what the fuck?
You should tell them, yeah.
And like, see what happens.
You still want me?
You want to suck on my sixth toe?
Oh, man.
Wait. Take it.
Well, don't watch Boomerang.
Take it to House Party 3. Eat the toe jam off her feet.
Get the TJ hors d'oeuvres.
Baby, get the TJ hors d'oeuvres. Get the crackers, baby. Get the wheat crackers, baby.
Wheat crackers.
Get the wheat ones.
Shit, you really got to do a Boomerang. Check her feet gross. And shit.
Check her feet. She make sure she ain't got hammer time.
Y'all are gross. Y'all know I'm a visual person. I'm not
funky
trying to
finger
see
production.
Stupid.
Funky Finger Productions.
Shit, man. What else is going on in the world? Oh, it's back to Kendrick, though, because we went on a tangent. He's having a, you know, somewhat of a beef with Big Sean.
Oh, God.
Yeah. And most rap analysts says that Big Sean is up one and Kendrick's zero. Comparing no interviews to The Heart Part 4. What are your thoughts about that one?
I disagree.
You disagree?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what do you got to say?
I'd say they're one for one. I don't think it's like, because it to me it's pretty leveled off. Like Big Sean, he didn't really go in as much as Kendrick did on part The Heart Part 4.
I say both of them niggas zero because they ain't saying names.
Yeah, both losers.
Fuck the subliminals.
I'm tired of the subliminal shit.
Say your name.
Say a fucking name.
Eli Corrupt.
And people said it like, I think Joe Budden said on his podcast, he was like, well, what if they said everything about you except for your name? I'm like, that's still subliminal, nigga.
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck. It's like, a nigga wearing a blue shirt with his blue headphones, with his white shorts, laughing and shit. Nah, nigga, say his name. Nigga. Right. There could be tens of millions of niggas who wearing blue shirt with white shorts. Nigga, like,
and he the only other nigga that say B.I.G. all the time.
Yeah.
He got a name tag that say Sean on it. Motherfucker.
I know. I didn't even make her make it obvious.
And
like,
he said he's from the D.
Yeah.
From the 313. And I ain't talking about Eminem.
He's talking about some Detroit versus everybody. Everybody versus you.
He think he's finally famous.
He think he in the Hall of Fame.
He think he's in the dark sky paradise.
That's another skit.
He say
idea.
I do
Where's
it.
Your book? Where's your book, Mark?
I think he don't.
Like, what the fuck, niggas? Is this rap it. Guess who, nigga?
Yeah.
You have to, like, go, like, okay, let me see. No, that can't be this rapper.
Does he have dreads? No.
Flick, 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 flick. Okay, it's down to these two. There's Drake and there's Big Sean. Maybe he's talking about both of them.
Is he brown skin?
Yeah.
Can you guess who? I win.
All the subliminals. Yeah, they might as well rap Guess Who because all these subliminals.
Rap Guess Who.
Does he have a Jesus piece?
Does he have?
They all do.
Does he have two chains?
No, but we know who does.
Flip, 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 flip.
Oh, it ain't you, two chains.
It ain't you, two chains. Flip. Just one flip. Just.
Does he claim that you don't want no problems with him?
Oh, my God.
Nope. Nope. No dreadheads niggas
does
in the lobby.
Does he wear yep. number 3 on his hat?
Guess, no. Flick. Just one flick.
Oh, man.
Does he have dreads? Yes. Flip, 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 flip.
I want to do a surprise call. Dun, should we call? All you motherfuckers say, oh, I want to talk to you. Hey,
right of you?
I'm only calling day one listeners until you motherfuckers leave a review.
Hey.
So, let's see. Who can we call? I know it's kind of late, though.
Yeah.
They have to be in Cali.
Oh, that's messed up. What if our Japanese... No, Japanese listeners, I don't know. You guys going to have a calling card or some shit. I don't know. Hey, our Japanese audience is growing, man.
Yeah.
It's growing.
You got to have a calling card.
Or Skype. Pull a Skype. Ooh. Skype calls out.
I like you.
And then they can actually see us.
I like Nessa. I love you, Nessa.
They're going to have a statue for her out there.
Yeah.
You on your world tour, Nessa.
You come, come.
Japan, I'm actually stopping by in China on our way to Bali.
Hey.
We were supposed to stop by.
Wait. International tour.
I got to pull a sway on her. Did she just stunt on us?
Oh, yeah. She's always stunt on us.
No. Shit, I was going to say, because we were supposed to go. We were supposed to stop by in Manila so I can see my peoples. Hey, but then they changed it to China.
I'm going to call right now. Y'all, this is very raw, y'all. So let's see.
She's like, shit, I'm going to Oceanside. That's it.
What is it? Phone a friend. Let's see if they answer.
We phone a friend. See if they answer.
Your call has been
sent a strike to voice.
Strike one.
Dun, dun, right. Dun.
Womp, 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 womp.
Who else can we call?
Did it say forwarded to voicemail?
Yeah.
That's what it says.
Whoever just forwarded it ain't shit.
She must be watching a movie.
They're not going to put no days out there.
We could have been a radio station trying to give them $100.
Right. I know, right?
Congratulations. You won 2 tickets to the Summer Jam.
You won tickets to the 90s party.
Right.
It's gonna be so fun next week, you guys.
Get your Key Sweat tickets, everybody.
Dude, it's gonna be so fun. I'm excited.
No, Sweaty Keith.
Oh, stupid.
Let's see. Let me check on this caller right here.
You thought this was 112? It's 211.
Let's see if this caller, this lucky guest, will pick up.
Let's see.
It's tickets up. It's on your call.
Taking live calls.
Live.
Ooh, baby, you live.
Motherfuckers.
Nope. All you niggas always asking us.
Yeah, motherfuckers, we can call now.
Call y'all niggas.
Nothing is safe.
Not even your phone.
Not your phone.
Not your phone, motherfucker.
Unless you forward us to the voicemail, then you're a piece of shit.
And you don't know what number is from. So
star 67.
Don't do that.
We don't play that shit.
We're not gonna answer back your calls.
Man, no one wants to talk to us, man.
They don't. It's just a start, that we're calling, you know?
Yeah, they ain't expecting. That's the beauty of it.
I was going to say that. That's the beauty of it.
That's the beauty of it.
What's that?
Huh?
Yeah. Why not?
I'm talking about day one listeners, man.
Yeah.
Not day one podcasters.
Ooh, what's that?
That sound like a video call.
Right?
Yes, it sounds like a video call. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Who that is?
I don't think we have contact.
You had contact with somebody.
Full of shit.
No contact. Like, it wasn't answering. It's gonna keep ringing and ringing.
Shit. Nah. Somebody ain't post answering now.
Oh, they can video call us. People internationally, they can video call us on Facebook and stuff like that.
Yeah, they can video call us.
Shit, you answer.
Call Tyrone.
You better call Tyrone.
call him.
But you can't use my phone.
You piece of shit.
You dumb bitch.
Stupid.
Damn, man, nobody want to answer.
No.
So understand, listeners, this is the safe house. We do whatever the fuck we want here.
Yes, live from the safe house.
You might be on the show.
If you want to be.
Oh, yeah. You never know. Your phone might be ringing. It could be the Jiggers Up podcast.
Ring-a-ling-ling. Ring-a-ling-ling.
Go edit all this shit out. No.
You better not edit this out.
Okay.
How dare you?
I guess we'll try another time.
You better not edit this out.
I guess no one wants to talk to us.
I turned it off. This is evil.
Aw, why you do that?
That's weak.
Oh, is it turned off? For real, for real? Or?
No, he's not turned off.
The FX.
The sound effects.
The sound effects. Oh, okay. I was like, oh.
Oh, yeah. We stepped it up. Ladies and gents, we got sound effects on deck.
Oh yeah.
All the way turned up. Or nah. These callers ain't, though.
You said what, Nessa?
All the way turned up.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know, we can't be hitting people up them with them U up texts.
Well, W-Y-D.
W-Y-D.
W-Y-D. W-Y-A.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Gotta be careful with all that.
Yeah. Bet you the only people that will answer, not the day ones. They'll be like, "Oh, what's up? Hey,
hi, yeah."
Like, well, leave a review.
Right.
Hang up on them.
Click.
First thing you ask. Oh, first and only thing you ask. You do that review yet? No. Well, tell me what this sound like tomorrow.
Click. Click.
Crazy.
Oh boy.
I guess no one wants to play with us.
Oh well.
Y'all missed out.
It wasn't meant to be.
It's hump day. They over there humping.
I don't blame them.
Hey man.
When you hum somebody or get a call from the Jiggas Up podcast,
you gotta get them rocks off.
Choose wisely.
Yay, man.
If I were you, I'll go with option number one. Get yours.
Internal cleansing.
Shoot. But yeah, I just wanted to like do this little exercise. Uh-oh. I thought it would be funny. Yeah. Or fun. You know, this sparked the idea of me asking this little discussion question. It's fun. And as I was watching the Dave Chappelle series, series on Netflix that he just came out, and he had Morgan Freeman do the narration, you know, in the introduction. So I was figuring, if your life was a movie, like, who would narrate your thoughts or the events that you're going through in your life?
Designer.
You have designer narrate, nigga. You have designer narrate your life.
Sense.
Oh my gosh.
That makes perfect sense for you.
He's going to his job.
He'll make a nigga's life sound like extra exciting.
Yeah.
Niggas on the keyboard like. Hey.
You know he's outside more than live.
None of us can roll our tongue and shit.
he's
whatever,
a master.
Marco.
I gotta use my lips. And
that's Roger Rabbit, actually.
It's designer today, motherfucker.
Oh, so designer. So you go with designer.
It's a joke. I'm not going with
Hey, that someone could have been like, yo, that's fucking dope. Designer, yeah. That's your narrator of your life.
Think of the Migos, homie.
Yo.
The Migos.
All set. Yeah. Kill it. Kmart. Walking to the down the street. Want to get something to eat. Hey, everyone's fine. I didn't give him a five.
I'm hungry.
What is going to
be this?
Got a hot dog and some juice. Hey. Juice!
Wait, say that one again. Got a hot dog is good.
Yeah, it's good. Get a hot dog and a juice.
Costco?
Oh, yeah.
Come with some relish.
I thought Bun B would be your narrator.
Oh, shit. Oh, so
he was like, walking down the street, his name was Kmart. Mart. Nigga's acting really stupid, but he's really smart. Yeah.
He's freestyling his narrative.
He chose.
That's a very good.
He passed on the blue when he went with the red, red.
Nah, you know who I think would narrate him? Sugar Free. I can hear Sugar Free narrating.
What are you gonna do now? Oh, you probably gonna wake up and take a piss and you're gonna go and brush your teeth and make some breakfast. What's that? I'm thinking some eggs and bacon and shrimp. I'm some sausages and waffles.
Stupid, so. Oh damn!
Whoa!
Man, carried away.
Three yeah. instruments.
That's right.
Like a guitar string.
Damn right.
Who would narrate me?
Who would narrate Nessa? That would be interesting.
Probably like an R&B singer or something like that.
An R&B singer?
Yeah. She's about to go to the gym. some shit. I don't know.
That sound like Thundercat.
Right.
Thundercat be another
I know.
Beach and meat.
Don't sleep. She's about to do some crunches.
Ooh, there's like no be, female okay. actress that you like, say, yeah, or
would it be a male or female?
Yeah, I'm saying it could be anybody. So yeah. I mean, that's you got a lot to choose from.
Like NBA players, Kobe.
Kobe
Bryant. Shaq. Yeah.
Kobe
Shaq.
Shaq.
Hey, Shaq.
Yes, sir.
Watching Nessa.
Don't start with that.
Nessa. She about to do some Uber driving. She picked up a passenger.
Can you take me to? Can you take me to Burger King? I'm hungry. I want a Whopper. Extra cheese.
Hey.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm Shaq. And I'm in the car with the Uber driver, Nessa. Hey. Pull over right here. I'm hungry.
Hey, I'm Shaq. I'm a sheriff.
I'm a sheriff.
Stupid. Hey. Put your seatbelt on. Let me think. I gotta think.
What about you, Easy?
Sugar Free. That's funny.
Sugar Free is a good one.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm not entirely sure who would narrate me. I'd probably, just for fun, I'd probably say like Usher or something. I don't know.
You kind of sound like Usher in a little bit.
Because it would start off like, yeah, man. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. It's fun.
He woke
know.
Up in the morning.
No, I don't know about no singing.
Oh, okay.
I tell him, like, you better not sing, motherfucker. You start singing, you need to take that over to Nessa. Like, start narrating her.
maybe Missy Elliott.
Missy Elliott? All right.
All right.
I can see that. It's kind of tight. It's kind of tight.
Not bad. What about you, Marco?
Man, that's a tough one. I know. Dish of Powdy. Y'all hear it? The fire track. Yeah. The fire track.
It's real in these streets.
So Lil Wayne is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Lil Wayne.
Welcome to the hood.
Lil Wayne, like,
you know what? You
Lil
know
Wayne,
what?
Like, I'm narrating. Yo, Marco's like, man. It's pretty hot in this motherfucker's seven. Yeah, man.
I got one for
man,
you.
I'm really
this nigga was stupid. I feel like
dying. You know what I'm saying? Like my daddy ain't giving me no money. You know, punk ass nigga, man. Daddy. Fuck my that. Daddy.
And this nigga Kodak Black talking about he want to knock a nigga out.
You stupid.
You ain't knock a nigga out because in front of my bitches, nigga.
I'm sorry, I'm on a tangent. I'm back to what I was saying. Yeah, Marco's going on it.
But you know, like. You know, I wander around a lot.
Yeah, fight my daughter first.
And, you know, I've been sipping on my lean too much, man. Like, I'm tired.
No. Who would narrate?
Who?
Tax Stone.
And yo's motherfucking tax. And I got motherfucking, this nigga yo is Marco.
Damn, what the fuck?
I'm too straight edge for tax and narrating my life. He'd be bored as fuck.
You bored as hell.
Nah, that nigga said he a civilian.
Not right now. Shit.
I'm surprised nobody didn't say like Samuel Jackson or some shit.
Samuel Jackson. Cool. I was thinking about the Samuel Jackson would just be say a lot of motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Rest in peace. I think Bernie Mac would have been dope.
Yeah, because that would have been my first choice if he was still here. Like,
hey, this nigga marked my head. This nigga think he's the motherfucking shit.
M to the motherfucking easy.
He's actually taking the shit.
And I told this motherfucker he need to stop fucking all them motherfucking bitches when he was single and get himself a good girl. Because this motherfucker ain't motherfucking listen to me. And I told that motherfucker one more motherfucking time. Samuel Jackson come in.
be like doing Samuel Jackson. I don't want to be loud.
No, I mean, you'd be loud. It's
but maybe I have Dave Chappelle. Maybe I have Dave Chappelle do my narration.
Oh,
folks.
Okay.
We have here a young podcaster named Yoas Marco, and he doesn't smoke reefer, nigga.
I was just talking about that with ATL. I was like, yeah, none of us smoke. I don't know why we were talking about
we're
that.
We're straight edge. I mean, they probably think it's like, man, you guys are fucking weird. You live in
we're
California.
Lame.
Right?
We don't smoke weed.
You were in Cali. You don't
and
smoke.
You don't smoke weed, nigga?
You well, rare, bro. Well.
You rare.
Hey, hold on, nigga. I have a government job, yo. I can't be fucking around smoking weed, man. Mm. I got responsibilities.
As the wise words of E40s. E40.
Ooh.
Square is a box of Apple Jacks, man. That's what I am.
For real, man.
Sharp corners.
Sharp corners for you, pimping. Pimp container.
Huey Lewis and the News.
I would give that one brother from House of Cards a shot. The dude who runs the barbecue shop. He has that deep raspy voice. It's pretty dope. Yeah. So
what about old boy that played as Cottonmouth in the Luke Cage series?
Oh, yeah.
Gilbert Godfrey.
Gilbert Godfrey would be obnoxious.
He'd have to be Cottonmouth as the character doing My Life. Because he was a dope character in the Luke Cage series.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's the only time I would consider him like, oh, yeah, for sure, man.
Cottonmouth. Yeah.
Because we did say anybody, so.
Shit, nigga, I could be a cartoon character.
I know I have Saitama narrating my life. Uncle, I could have been talking to the country.
Ah. Vegeta. That's who would narrate Nessa's life. Pacquiao.
Oh, Manny Pacquiao.
Manny Pacquiao. Yeah.
Si, Vanessa.
Filipino.
Vanessa.
You went and punted, Nisa?
No.
You went and punted. No taking the tobo. You want the cheeseburger?
You want
cheeseburger with price?
I hate you guys.
You want some bullock?
Y'all
shout out to my Filipinos, man. I fucks with y'all.
Yeah,
I went to Morris High School.
45%
Filipinos, nigga. So
I
used to play pasoidos.
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 Oh, yeah.
You know about that.
Yeah, pasoidos is shit, man.
Oh, shit, man.
Oh, yeah. A little bit. Man, I go to every baby shower and all that shit, man. Hell yeah. Oh, I'm down my street.
Oh, yeah, man.
Princess and I, when we used to throw the little co-ed football games, that's all they was looking forward to. Like, oh, y'all going to come to the game? You bringing lumpia? Like, what the fuck?
Damn.
Princess and I used to actually hand make the lumpia. And the way lumpia is made is with ground pork and ground beef. But we used to make ours with ground turkey and ground chicken. But so people would always want us to bring it. And after a while, it just got too much. So I just order it from a specific place that I've been going to for years. And
you got
to
give me that info.
Someone had told me when I was in Atlanta the last time.
Hey, y'all hit me.
And then I posted a picture on my Snap with my Batman outfit. Someone's like, you owe me some ass and some lumpia. I'm like, what the
damn,
fuck?
Damn,
this nigga said ass and lumpia.
I want some ass and lumpia.
Hey, yes.
Ass is on the menu.
I was like, what? Like, who says that?
I don't know, but
hi, my name
hey,
is
if you
help
deliver
you?
It, you be a bad motherfucker.
I want some ass.
Some ass and some lumpia?
Damn.
Well, we are.
It's like, hi, can I help you? I want some ass and some side of lumpia, please.
Right. You be like spreading your butt naked on the bed. Eat with
I want some legs
everywhere.
And thighs.
Well, it depends on
the sweet sour sauce in my. Okay, let me stop.
Sweet and sour sauce
in your.
This is a safe house after dark.
Sweet and sour sauce.
Safe house broad daylight. It's still dirty. still get it dirty.
Dude, now you got the listeners going sweet and sour sauce. Where? Hold on.
Keep talking.
I got to fix myself up.
Yeah, keep talking. Hey, well, I feel sorry you guys working out right now. We already messed up.
You should just pull up in like
just start
the
talking.
Batman, little Batman outfit that got him going with the thingaloopia. Like,
Let's do this.
Like a Carl's Jr. commercial.
And you know how like they be spreading like honey and shit, but instead it'll be the sweet and sour sauce. Like,
ooh. Right. First I'm gonna work you out, then I'm gonna feed you.
Y'all look crazy.
Stuffed.
Oh my god.
These one word expressions. Bro.
Eating in slow motion and shit.
Slow motion.
With symphony. Right, with symphony music playing.
But you got it has to be Filipino.
Slow motion.
Y'all are dumb. Leave you can take the Filipino. Bebo.
Hell yeah.
Shout out to my peoples though.
I still gotta wait for my my ancestry DNA thing to come through.
How long does it take?
It takes him like forever.
Is it like forever? I'm waiting for it.
Forever and a day.
It's a pretty long time.
Yeah, it's a pretty long time.
Forever.
I can't
ever,
wait for that.
Forever.
My grandmother recently did that.
So, you know, when I take it, I'm just like, shit. I'm fucking with people. I'm like, it says 100% black, nigga. African, West Africa, Nigeria, nigga. I've been a full-blooded nigga all this time, you mother suckers.
walk around here with full confidence, like I'm blacker than you.
I'm blacker than you, mother sucker.
I ain't been in sun that long.
I don't give a fuck. I get sunburned. I don't get it. If I got light eyes, I get sunburned, and I have a red beard and little blonde streaks in my head.
Beard,
I don't give a fuck, nigga. I'm blacker than you.
He killed tigers and skinned them and hid under their skin.
Oh my god, motherfucker! Y'all are dumb.
Made a coat out of their skin and
don't fuck with me, motherfucker.
Stayed away from the sun.
Nah, fuck around. Man, find I out stayed you, in hella, tree houses. You hella Native American and get some dough.
Shit.
I'll be
living in the reservations. I'm having a fat ass studio. Podcasting.
We're live.
Podcasting and voiceovers.
24/7,
365. I'll be like with the Dago Braves, hanging out with Poodizzi and shit. Wow. Like, nigga, I'm at the res. What up?
I'm a Brave.
Keep fucking the res and shit. Give me that Kumiye money. Kumiye, whatever you want to call it.
Kumiye.
Kumiye is my money.
You stupid.
Shit. Find out I have some native like that shit. I'm just saying. And that's the case. I'm going to say, fuck Andrew Jackson, too. Motherfucking Trail of Tears. Got my people walking on that long. Man, fuck him. Fuck Andrew Jackson. But a dub is still cool with me though. I hope they really get replaced by Harriet Tubman.
Man, that'd be dope.
So I can say Tubman.
You got them tubs.
Nigga, put a tub on that, nigga.
Better tub on that. Fuck a dub.
I got them tubs.
Fuck a dub, nigga. What's a tub, nigga?
Man, I want one.
Tub.
I hate y'all.
I want 100,000. I want 100,000 full of tubs.
You want Benji's? Nah, nigga, I want tubs, nigga.
Yeah, tubs.
I'm sitting on tubs.
Tub magazine.
So I know about magazine. This tub life.
Tub life?
I'm in a tub full of tubs.
I can sound like Young
Jeezy.
How
old are you, tubs?
Young Jeezy Blake.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm in the club with the tubs.
Hey, that might be a song. I'm in the club with the tubs.
Yeah.
You heard it first.
That's right.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
When the pies get high and we ball outrageous.
Oh, man.
Don't shut up to the club unless you got them tubs.
It's really going to be like tubs.
Magic City full of tubs.
Magic City full of tubs.
Hey.
Dude, we need to go somewhere though. Like, we need to
go to a laundromat.
This nigga's at a laundromat. You got some dirty clothes, nigga?
We're live at the Laundry Mat.
I'm Nick Cannon and he's Nivea.
Oh, Lord.
I'm headed to the Laundry Mat.
Oh, my Marcos God. R. Kelly.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Whoa.
I don't have to pee yet, guys.
Well. We need to take a field trip. We got to go on a road trip.
We're at the park.
Nigga, you going to Bali, and I thought I did something because I went to Universal Studios and shit.
She wants us to get on a fucking bus while she about to go to Bali.
I want all of us to
I'm going to Chuck E. Cheese.
To go on a world tour.
Go on a world
or
tour.
Or a city tour, whatever.
That's a world tour.
It's going to happen. It's going to happen.
It's going to happen. Motherfuckers want to hear us talk in different parts of the world. I'm going to look at them like, you're a fucking weirdo, but I love you. Because y'all the reason why I'm here.
Right.
And I'm only here because I don't want to get fined.
Flagstaff.
Wow.
Flagstaff.
What is a random town you think we'll get booked in? Or booked on, or whatever. Like a random town, like you never heard.
Somewhere in one of the Dakotas.
Dakotas.
I think we'll be somewhere over there. Like, what the fuck is this?
Bon Toms.
I'm like, man, this is promoter gonna give us some money. That's
everybody stand back to back.
Janky promoter.
That's when I start. We really start having to consider having like really like fucking managers and agents and shit.
Yeah.
So we don't want to
sound hard like Hollywood. Like, talk to my agent. Nigga, I'm talking to you. Hey, nigga. Hey, this booking shit, nigga. All I do is podcast and talk, nigga.
I'm just a podcast.
I show up and talk.
I just show up and talk, nigga. Like, the logistics and the bookings and shit, you talk to my manager right there.
I show up and talk, and I leave and have cookies.
What
will be your writer request? He's like, nigga, when I get in the locker room, I want
all green M&M's, motherfucker.
Right? Something outlandish.
Dick.
What?
Huh? The fuck?
Wait,
the fuck?
What?
I said, you're a dick.
Oh, I know.
We didn't hear your A part. All we heard was, we over here making requests, and that sounded like your request.
That sounded like something Nessa would request. Hold up.
Like, Kelly, are you telling something that we don't know? Maybe that's why you haven't had a girl around.
Look. Just hear me out.
I said, you're a dick. I guess. I pulled it.
Let's not talk about it.
Let me paint a picture for you, Kelly.
Okay.
This is all I heard. Look, I was like, green M&M's, motherfucker. And then all I heard after that was dick. Like, what?
We all looked at each other like, hold on.
No, it's like how you point. He's like,
record
he's,
scratch.
He's just like, he's the biggest.
Jiggins of exclusive.
Oh.
I'm kidding.
Like that. Nothing. I guess nothing is safe.
Nessa wants to watch.
Damn, you did the gunshot. No, like, no, it's like how you did. He's like, you threw him. He's like, with the shootout fingers, like, dick. And he's just like that. Exactly how you did.
Because that's all we heard.
Because look, you lean back.
Turn your headphones up, goddamn.
You pull like a Howard Stern move or something. You lean back and just jump into the mic like, dick. Yeah, that's my request. that's your request.
Oh,
yeah.
It's like, you're a dick.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
All right.
I don't know, man.
If you were Vince McMahon, all we would have heard was fire, not your fire.
Fire.
Yeah, that's it.
I like
and Nessa. You'd have to have a separate dressing room, right?
Yeah,
you request
course.
Shit like that.
I love Lola Fallopian too.
Well, no, and they better not fuck that. Up. They better not fuck up. Put the nigga in the wrong room.
She like send me a dark skinned nigga about 6 feet tall,
but
seven and a half inches, 8 inches, maybe 2 inches of girth, two and a half, 3 inches of girth. And he better have a beard.
And some food.
Yeah, right.
And some food.
nigga have some carne asada fries in front of his naked body.
Yeah.
Bon appetit.
Oh, my God.
Then I want another motherfucker rubbing my feet while I'm eating carne asada fries.
And rubbing my booty.
Booty rubs are a must.
See? Take note, fellas.
This is going to make weird requests. And I want a third one licking the carpet.
Oh, my gosh, y'all. I don't even get down like that. Listeners, don't listen to what the fuck they're talking about.
I'm talking about literally the carpet.
Lick the carpet.
Walk into the dressing room. I want this carpet clean, motherfucker.
Lick it, spin.
I was about to say, that's the only carpet they would be licking. Because, you know.
Yeah. Alrighty then.
Yeah.
Well, on that note,
On that note,
segue.
Speaking of carpets.
Shout out to Terrell the Dad. If you want to clean it, if you want your carpet clean.
Speaking of carpets, Stanley Steamer.
Hello.
What up? What up?
What up, though?
We're calling one of our day one listeners. We got Tasha on the line.
Hey!
You're on the show.
Is that,
oh, my God. Up, I cannot believe you.
What up, girl?
What up? Yep, yep.
Well, you believe
what
us.
Is going on, y'all?
Hey. Nothing much. First of all, we want to thank you for your support.
Yes.
Listening to us.
She didn't have a choice.
Hey, boo.
I know.
You caught her.
Hey.
You don't have
You're
a
so welcome. I love you guys.
Second
oh my gosh,
of all,
I'm so excited right now.
Second of all, why didn't I get invited to the silent party in Hollywood, though?
Uh-oh. You know what? Oh my goodness. I thought about this later after I got home. I said, oh my God, I forgot about Mark. I keep forgetting you're not in San Diego. I keep forgetting you're in
you
San
see the
Diego.
Look on his face.
You know
it's priceless.
You see the priceless.
No pun intended.
They don't know my name. Fuck that.
It would have been so lit if you were there. I saw the one you guys went to and I was like, oh man, I wish I was there.
Yeah.
So you I know it would have been bomb if you went with me.
But, yeah. but
down
you
to the 90s party.
But you met Lil Rel. You met the hero of Get Out.
I did. And you know what's crazy? I didn't even know who he was until somebody pointed him out to me. And I was like, oh, that's who that was? I mean, I was faded. Granted, I was faded.
I've seen that on the IG.
He was faded too, though, believe it or not. But yeah. He was really nice, really friendly, funny, of course. But yeah, he was in there moving and shaking. I just didn't know who he was the whole night until like the end. And then we took that photo and I was like, oh, okay, you're cool.
Girl, come down to San Diego next week. Come to the 90s party.
Man, girl, I would if I could, girl. You know, parent life, mom duty.
I feel it.
I won't be free. But man, I'm definitely going to turn up with you guys at some point this year, though. Like, that's a must.
Yeah, we supposed to have been turning up in May or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, Tosh, we were talking about when the podcast goes on tour, what would you think be one of the weirdest towns you think will be booked? Like a certain like city, like some middle of the nowhere city that with a small population will book us.
Bustin' Nuts, Arkansas.
This is in California?
Anywhere.
Somewhere that I think would be interested.
Something
out of the ordinary.
Just a random town. It could be like 100 people there.
Modesto, California.
Modesto.
Hey, that's my hood, Modesto. Central Valley. We out here.
Promoters.
NorCal all day, every day. somewhere random.
Like a random place
you've been. Kansas.
You know what?
What's a random place you've been to?
The weirdest place I've been to visit?
Yeah, like, it was like, where the hell are we?
You know what? Random. But you guys know when you're driving to Las Vegas and you pass through that city that's like XYZ, XYZ or something like
that?
That's
weird as fuck. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like
XYZ, so weird. Like little towns,
or something.
Yeah, little towns like that where you're like, where am I?
Like, how do you even pronounce
a town,
that
I think
shit?
way up north called Weed, like when you're going like what? Up towards the border, like the northern border of California, there's a town called Weed that I've driven through. That was awkward.
Wow.
Was it like the Hills Have Eyes type shit, you know what I mean?
Fuck that.
Yeah, it was just odd. I was like, I need to pass through here quickly. I don't need to be here very long.
This is dope, man. Yeah. We interact
but you know what? Honestly, it's not even a small town, but I think like parts, little cities in the Bay would like you guys, like Hayward. Oakland for sure. What are the some other little Pittsburgh? There's a Pittsburgh, California.
Oh,
they
yeah.
might mess with y'all. Like, Yeah, just little surrounding cities in the Bay. They, you know, there's all types of art out there, and they love broadcasts like this. You know, podcasters and other artists and singers and spoken word, all that artsy stuff. So yeah, it's heavy up there.
Artsy fartsy. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So
artsy fartsy. That's why I love y'all.
Hit her with the other question.
And we love you back.
Hit her with the other question. Oh yeah,
and we were talking about writer requests, like how would we act, you know, if you get big time and shit. And we were just saying, like, Kenlin said dick. That wasn't his writer request. We were just fucking with him.
Wait, what is it?
It was a misunderstanding. Because he was saying something. We couldn't hear what he was saying beforehand, but the thing that stood out to him was dick, because he projected his voice to the mic really loud, and me and Easy and Nessa felt jealous. She was like, "Hey, what? That's what I would request, nigga."
Oh my goodness!
Basically, Kellen was calling me a dick because I said I would request green M&Ms. Yeah, and I guess.
Oh, like if you were on tour and you got like super famous.
Yeah.
Why the green ones, Mark?
Because they green. Green is money.
That's money.
Green is go.
That's money right there.
Yeah, green means go. Never stop.
Only money, but no envy though. Take Only that, money, no that, envy around that, here.
Yep.
Can't stop, won't stop.
And then I said Nessa probably requests like a 6 foot tall, dark skinned dude, probably with like an 8-inch long with
Beard gang.
Gray sweatpants.
We forgot the gray sweatpants.
Yeah, because they're going to be hanging on the chair.
With some kind of side of fries. With some kind of side of fries.
Say
that. And have another dude.
You said plus what?
With some kind of side of fries. With some
food. Some carne asada fries.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. All day. I think I would join in with her with that. Cause, believe it or not, I've never had carne asada fries.
What?
I've never had carne asada fries. You guys got to change my life.
You
yeah.
need to bring yourself.
You need to come down here and get you some carne asada fries.
I haven't been living life, apparently.
You haven't.
If you'd have hit me up in L.A., I know a spot out there I could have
took
you to.
Fuck that. It ain't San Diego.
See, I'm so mad that I forgot about you, Mark. Oh, my God. I know you would have came with me and turned up.
I forgot he wasn't in L.A.
I forgot he wasn't in San Diego.
Yep.
I'm thinking he's in San Diego. I keep forgetting you're in L.A. Oh, so the next time I'm there,
she gonna
my
forget.
Phone as a reminder.
She gonna forget.
Hit up Mark.
She gonna forget.
You said he gonna forget or I'm gonna forget.
You gonna forget.
I probably will. I'm not even gonna try to gas y'all right now.
It's all right. At least you be honest.
Yeah, and that's what we respect. That's what we respect. You know,
nothing
honesty.
Is safe.
Nothing is safe. You know what I mean?
Nothing is ever safe. You already know this, Marco. You already know this. With all the discussions we've all had, nothing is ever safe.
Nothing is ever safe. Yeah, this is dope.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, man, that's what we want to do. We want to interact with our listeners. And like I said, Tasha's been the day one supporter, you know, in the early stages.
Repping. All the way up here. What am I, like 7 hours north of you guys?
Like six.
Damn.
About six.
Yeah.
You know what
I'm
mean?
Super far.
She's super.
We know that much.
You are far.
Hella far.
Wait, but I want to know the other question. Who would you choose to
Oh yeah, we had another thing. It's like, who would narrate your life if you had a celebrity?
Could be anybody,
anything, any character, any person. Like, who would narrate your life?
Who would narrate my? You said narrate my life.
Yes. Yeah.
This is good. What can I think of? Like a super, you know what? Seth MacFarlane.
Wow.
Seth MacFarlane. I love, because he's such a dick. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, he's just such a dick. I just love it. I love his real voice. You know, isn't he like the voice of Stewie? Like, that's his real voice.
He's the voice of Peter and Stewie.
And Brian.
Yeah.
Brian
well, no,
is his
I know
real
that,
voice.
But I mean, like, his
Brian
real
is his
voice.
Actually, yeah,
his real
Brian,
voice is
I think Brian is his real voice.
Yeah, Brian. Yeah, yeah. So I love, like, when he's on, like, award shows and he's presenting things, I'm just like, I love his voice, man. I could just listen to him all day and just it's hilarious to me. So, yeah, Seth MacFarlane for sure. What do you guys say to that?
Kenlin, he had what? What he had? Who he had? Kmart.
The designer.
Yeah, he said designer. He said designer.
Oh no. I would turn that off after 1 minute, literally 60 seconds. I'd be like, cool. I was talking about his life. That's enough.
She said, cool. Cool. That's cool.
Cool. Yeah, that's cool. Who's next? No. That's messed up.
And then I think Nessa had Kobe.
No, y'all said Kobe. They said Kobe. They said Pacquiao.
Oh yeah, we said Manny Pacquiao. That would have been hilarious. Yeah.
Pacquiao. I don't know if you want Manny representing. I said Missy Elliott.
Oh yeah, she said Missy Elliott.
Oh, Missy would be dope because Missy would be like an MC, like she'd be like a DJ, like an MC, like a hype woman.
Yeah,
that would be dope. That's a good one. That's a good one. Who'd you say, Mark?
I said Usher, and then I changed it to Bernie Mac.
Bernie Mac. Oh, you know what? I would mess with Chris Rock. I would have Chris
Rock. I like that one. Yeah. So are you giving that to me? Yeah. Is that me? Chris Rock? That's the one you give it to me?
He's always turnt. Like, he's always just on, like, a trillion, super loud. You're going to listen to him. He's always yelling. I don't know. Like, that just would be a good representation of my life.
He's Chris. There you go.
I know, right?
Everybody hates Chris. Yeah. There you go. So, I mean.
Right. Marco, who'd you say?
I said Dave Chappelle.
Oh, my God. Yes. How did I forget about Dave? I love him. Yes. You guys love his specials? I'm going to go ahead and say yes.
Oh, yeah. I watched the special. I watched it twice.
Yeah, they were hilarious.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I've watched them a good 4 times each. I'm obsessed.
I'm just waiting on the Chris Rock specials to come through.
Yep, I'm waiting for them.
Oh, those are coming through?
Yeah. Chris Rock going to have some special on Netflix, too.
Yeah,
he already got some deals and stuff for it.
Yeah, he got deals set up. Okay. Netflix ain't playing. They,
you guys heard about that money that Dave got from that.
Oh, from Dave got like 60 mil?
Yeah, they said 60 mil. And it's crazy because he already had them like stored. Like, they were just chilling. He'd already recorded them, and he's like, they just bought them from him. That's dope.
Yeah,
that's super dope. Like, how do you just be like, oh, here you go, here are these tapes, and thank you for the 60 mil. Good doing business with you, like,
right,
baby.
Hey,
baby, what is you doing?
Right.
Shit, they are Netflix. So, hey, why not?
Shit, get that money.
This is true. Mm-hmm. Netflix is hella winning. Everybody I know got Netflix.
Everybody's winning.
Netflix is trying to take HBO
or without the chill. You know, with or without the chill.
I prefer with.
Oh, we know.
That's why you the homie.
We know.
That blows right. Too well. But yeah, Tosh, we just wanted to test this out. You were a guinea pig, but at the same time, we wanted to show you love in return by having you on the show. On our,
I don't know what we're gonna call it.
Our welcome to the safe house segment, I guess.
Yep.
So we're gonna call people
the safe house segment.
But the thing is, for people who want to be called in, they have to leave us a rating and review. But since we know you and you're a day one listener, you gotta pass on that one.
You gotta pass.
Well, don't
baby.
I feel special? VIP in this thing right here. Yep. I feel hella special.
Shit, we just glad you answered.
Yeah.
Appreciate that.
Hey, you know what? You know what?
Been sleep.
Marco was texting me, and I was like, no, don't call me. I'm nervous. Don't call me. I didn't know what it was about. He's like, just pick up the phone. And I'm like, no, I can't. I didn't know what it was.
You did well, though. You know. You did well. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, girl. All right. I'll catch up with you guys soon.
Yeah,
all
right.
Thank you for calling me.
Yeah, you need to physically come through on the show.
That would be dope.
Oh, yeah. I'd be honored. Believe me. Anytime.
All right, Tosh. Well, you have a good one.
Yes,
ma'am. We appreciate that. Coming all the way from Fresno, Clovis.
Modesto.
Oh, yeah.
Scent Val Cali. Yep. We connected. Like
Val Cali. Be repping.
All right. You have a good one.
All right, girl.
All right, you too. Bye.
Bye. Well, wasn't that fun?
Yeah, that was fun. Shit, man. I think we, shit, it's getting late. So
yeah, I think we've been on this bitch for like 2 hours.
Yeah, that's probably like the longest episode.
Right? Hey.
Ever, no time. You know what? I wouldn't be mad at you if you edited some of it too, because it was a lot of like us just playing. Like,
yeah. So you can edit it. So that's a good thing.
If not, you know, let him ride out.
This is a safe house. We do
a safe house segment.
Or we could do part 1, part 2.
Split it in half. Either or.
Yeah.
Hey, should I do my goodbye thing?
Goodbye. You gotta.
Well, first of all, shout outs.
Go ahead, Kmart.
Come on, we waited.
Yeah.
Shout out to me.
That was very subtle.
Thank you.
I thought one of these days Kim was gonna be like, knock knock, who's there? Shock. Shout out to me. I thought he was gonna pull that one these days.
Stupid. I can see that happening though.
He's cracking up.
All right, that's what's up.
Shout out to Miss Karen again. Congratulations on your job opportunity.
She better be listening to this podcast episode. Maybe shout outs you be giving her.
I know. And shout out to my sis Princess for that random text that she sent me yesterday. Just basically, I don't want to say praising me, but she had
give you some encouraging words.
Yeah, like, and it came out of nowhere. She just randomly was thinking about me. It was just
the Pacquiao.
We love Princess too.
I literally cried. Princess, like, that's how touching it was.
Oh no, don't cry. Snap. Don't cry. You big girl.
It was beautiful. It was beautiful.
You have your big girl
panties
on.
Big girls cry too. Shit.
You got your big girl panties on. You can't cry.
Only when you go too deep.
Goodbye.
That leaves it to Easy, man.
Shout outs to Monica.
Shout outs to Monica.
Hey,
shout outs to Tosh for
yes,
joining us on this episode.
Yes.
Yeah, man. Safe house.
Shout out to her answering the motherfucking phone. Fuck everybody else. No, I'm just playing. Just playing.
But no, like I said, if you want us to give you a call on, you know, if you want to get in the safe house, you have to leave us a review on whatever you listen to us on.
Ever.
You know what I mean? iTunes, SoundCloud don't count, nigga, because no, there's no reviews on SoundCloud. But if you decide to follow us, that helps out too. So I might give you a pass on that one. And what else? And
you already said all the different spots.
Yeah, right? iTunes, Stitcher,
Google Play.
Or any other podcasts and streaming apps that play our shit. Anywhere you can find us. We're there. We're trying to be. Oh, shit. Shout outs. I just want to say shout outs to MEZY, man. Getting the equipment.
Woo!
You know what I mean?
This is, man.
This is going to be a lot of fun. You know, we're going to probably play around a lot. This is more loose, you know what I mean? But at times, we're going to record in the studio as well. We're just trying to deliver more content to you guys. So, in the words of Kmart, if you're taking a big shit, if you're driving, if you're working out.
If you're taking a big shit.
If you're,
be
you know,
careful if you're working out. Just saying.
Be careful. Disclaimer. If you're taking a big shit. Don't push too hard. Oh
my gosh. The laughter might push it all out. Shit.
Intestines might follow too. Shit. Be careful out there.
Oh no.
You might push a hernia out your motherfucking ass.
Oh no. Oh man.
Well, nothing is safe, Nessa.
Nothing is safe.
Not even your booty hole.
Says the nigga who wants ass in lumpia. Not MEZY, but the guy who requested it to her. So you better watch out, Nessa.
Right.
Niggas want ass and lumpia these days.
Ass and lumpia. Ass and lumpia.
Yeah, fuck the titties, right?
You forgot you. Damn the titties, Gina.
Damn titties. Ass and lumpia.
Ass and lumpia. Fuck it up in the booty.
Booty.
See what I have to deal with, you guys.
Yes, she lightweight clinched too. She's like, ooh. Shit.
Bubbles and bubbles
she
and bubbles.
She that.
All right, man. So if you enjoy listening to this podcast as much as we love making it, because we
wobbles
do.
And wobbles and wobbles.
We do what we love and love what we do. And if you're not being your motherfucking self, you know what I got to say.
The jig is up.
And we out. Oh, shit. That was loud. Get it.